Now, this video is not about reminding you about a deadline for the submission of the applications. No. This video is about revealing to you why you should take advantage now and create an application on Pi Network. That is what this video is all about. I will tell you exactly what Pi app is, because most of us thought that it's very hard. You need to be a guru. You need to know so much about blockchain or know some, you know, programming languages like Solidity for you to create application on Pi Network. Okay, it's a no-no. In this video, I will tell you exactly what a Pi application is, how you can create on the Pi Studio, and how you can create on the developer portal as well. Okay, because you can create using the Pi App Studio, and also you can self create using the developer portal. So I will try to give you a blueprint of what these applications are and how you can create them. Okay, it's not something you cannot do as a pioneer. Today, according to the timeline, as you can see here, October 15th, 2025, final submission deadline. All final submission are due, including the app listing via developer portal, demo video, and submission form. So for those that participated on the ongoing Pi hackathon, today is the final day for submission of the application. Okay, now if you go to your Pi browser, okay, and under the Pi app, if I click on Mainnet app, you can see this Hackathon 25 tab here. Okay, Mainnet is active. If I click on Hackathon 25, now you can see the applications that was submitted for this ongoing Pi Hackathon. And if I scroll down, you can see that we have 20 nests. Okay, so then each of these nests contain 10. Okay, if you count, you can see that it contains 10. So that means roughly 200 applications have been submitted for this ongoing Pi Network Hackathon. So it's a very big success. So now if I click on App Studio, for example, you can see that, let me go ahead and go to my app. You can see that I have an application pending, okay, that I have to publish it. So I created this application using the App Studio. I intended using this application to solve some KYC problems, okay, that the pioneers are facing. You understand? Now, if I go back, I try creating something via the developer portal. Let me see whether it will load. Okay, so here you can see another application. I call it Oga Investor Pi Token Centralized Exchange. Now, this second application, which I want to develop myself somehow, I intend creating a centralized exchange for Pi Network where you can place some limit orders and some other orders aside the normal, you know, Pi Network DEX functionalities. Now, these applications are already in development. I didn't participate for the Pi Hackathon because I wasn't stable then, okay? So, but what I'm trying to tell you is this. Creating applications on Pi Network is not as hard as we think. Now, what is Pi App? Pi application is nothing but a web application, okay? Now, if you don't have any, you know, technical knowledge at all about creating a website, you can use the App Studio. And what exactly is the App Studio? If you go to Testnet, you will see so many applications, okay, that have been created in the App Studio. Now, the idea around this is this. You don't know how to create applications, but Pi Network or Pi Core team are gurus in creating applications in the Pi ecosystem. Now, using the Pi Studio, you kind of give them instruction of the kind of application you want them to create for you. Define the functionalities you want in the app you want them to create for you. Whether you want a payment system, you want to verify the pioneers, you want to check whether they've passed KYC and a whole lot of that. So try to be comprehensive enough, well detailed, and define everything you want in your application. Now the Pi core team at the back end will create your application for you. That was why when I visited my, you know, the application for which I called KYC Monkey, it's still pending. That means they are still creating it at the back end. So with Pi Studio, you can still create a very robust, you know, application for Pi Network. Now, aside that, you can use a developer portal to create application. This is where it's interesting, because for this other application I created, you can see the process where I was creating the application in the Pi App Studio, the naming. You can see what I named the application, KYC Monkey, app description, assist Pi Network pioneers on KYC related issues, app language, English, education category. Now you upload, you know, your logo for your application. You can use Canva to make sure that, you know, the dimension is correct, 1024 by 1024 pixel. Okay, so you need to make sure that you format your logo, as you can see me doing it on the application on Canva. And when you are done, you go ahead and submit. And after submitting, you need to, you know, pay a certain amount of Pi, which is 1 Pi for me, as you can see here. You need to pay 1 Pi. Now, once that payment becomes successful, now you have given your command. You need to give Pi Network time to create the application for you. It might take days, it might even take weeks, depending on the functionalities you want in your application. So for me, I use ChatGPT to generate the functionalities I wanted. I kind of summarize the whole thing, because in this prompt for description, it must be 1,000 characters maximum. So you can see on your screen. So you summarize everything so that it will be less than 1,000 and post. So give Pi Network time to create the application for you and launch it. Now, after launching the application, if you want other functionalities in the application, you can still query them to add those functionalities for you. So it's very simple. I have an idea. I want to build a website or an application. I have the idea of what the application will do, but I don't have the technical knowledge. What will I do? I will hire someone who is a web developer or an app developer to develop the application for me. It's as simple as that. So the pioneers, if you have a creative idea of an application that you can build that will add, you know, to the Pi Network ecosystem, the utility of the ecosystem, if you have it, you know, well figured out, the blueprint is in your head, all you need to do is to use maybe ChatGPT, query ChatGPT very well to give you the functionalities you want in that application. Okay, now paste it in the description and submit. Pay your Pi, which is 1 Pi, and allow the Pi Studio to do the work at the back end. And when your application goes live, if you want something else, you can still add. That is Pi Studio. Okay, now after that, I went ahead to try doing something using the developer portal. Okay, I've not been stable, but I think now I'm a bit stable. Now, you need to first of all agree to the terms and conditions. Make sure you read it if you're interested. And when you are done, go ahead and click on this new app icon here. You can see the plus icon. Now, you click on it. Okay, so you go ahead and create an application. You can see the fields here. App name, you need to name your application. For me, I named it Elga Investor, exchange for Pi Network. You need to add the description of what the application will do for the ecosystem, because very important, you don't just create an app. It must be an app that, you know, adds to the ecosystem. Okay, now here the app network, you can select Testnet or Mainnet, but it's always advisable, if you are building, it's always advisable to, you know, test your application, okay, on the Testnet before you go Mainnet. So I selected Testnet. Now you can see the Testnet app visibility, of course, public, app hosting, I have self-host. For now, hosted by Pi Network, I've not gone live, so you can only create a self-hosted application. Now you have your app URL, your app development URL, and you know a whole lot of things to do. Okay, here. So I'm yet to complete this particular process. You can see you have 10 steps to complete. Okay, if I click on the checklist, so you can see the checklist. Okay, I need to configure the hosting, connect app wallet, code your application. You need to write the code yourself. Now configure apps development URL. So there are a lot of steps for you to take before you can finish, you know, creating your application. All right. Now, this is not hard if you have idea about web development. Okay. Every web developer can create an app on Pi Network. You understand? All you need is your basic, you know, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and some, you know, frameworks. You understand? Because Pi have SDK and APIs to, you know, call from your website to integrate with, you know, the ecosystem. So it's something that developers, especially when it has to do with creating apps using the developer portal, only developers, web developers will understand. Okay. But at the same time, if you don't have such knowledge, the App Studio is fine, believe me. So a recap of the whole thing. I believe that if you really want to take advantage of this new functionality coming on Pi Network, which is token creation, you need to be a developer. Okay, because I believe that is developers that will create the tokens that you will trade on the Pi Network DEX. It's the developers that will create the tokens that you will buy or sell. You understand? And you know that most times developers are the ones, or token creators are the ones that, you know, make it. You understand? Because if you don't create a token, you buy. Now you are buying based on speculations. You buy and believing that the price will go up so that you sell and make money. Okay? But those that created the tokens, we make more of the money. So right now, I want to leave you with this advice. Start thinking about an application that you can create that will add to Pi Network's utility. Just start thinking about it. You understand? Check other ecosystems like Solana, you know, Ethereum, BNB. What are the functionalities they have there that you can replicate on Pi Network? There are so many of them. So many, not just DEX or centralized exchanges or liquidity pools, providers, or whatever. There are so many functionalities you can create, just replicate from other ecosystems in Pi Network. Once you can figure that out, now give Pi Network a strong, detailed instruction of what you want in your application, and believe me, they will create it for you. So that's what's up. Let's keep believing that Pi Network will make millionaires at the end of the day, for those that believe.